ourselves unto you. And Father, as you see fit, Lord, I ask that you will bless your people financially, bless them spiritually, bless them with the wisdom and the insight of your love and your truth, your mercy and your grace. And Father, we thank you once again that we are able to come boldly before you in the grace of throne. And Father, as I have heard the angels speak, holy, holy, holy is the Lamb of God. And Father, as I stand at your sacred office, God, prepared to minister your holy word, I'm asking you, Holy Spirit, to use me as a polished shaft, that I may decrease and the Holy Spirit may increase, not only in me, but in this place. And Father, that you will release a rhema word, a right now word for your people, that they will stand as tall as the giants that we see in the land. For Father, we are greater than them and more powerful than them because we walk in the spirit of truth. How thy word is truth, that you will bless us this day with the oracles of your word. And they will speak unto our hearts and to our minds that we give our tithes and that we give our offerings, God, but we give our faculties unto you, which is a holy God, that you may increase us as you increase the tithe and the offering. So shall we be increased this day with much of your revelation and illumination of your love, your loyalty, your honesty, and your spirit that dwell within. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, give Jesus a hand praise this morning. Oh, give him a hand praise this morning by the glory of Christ Jesus. We thank him again this day. You know, it's good to be in a place where you can move in the spirit. It's good to be in a place where there's joy. Many don't understand and never have come in contact with the spiritual things of God. The Bible says it's a dangerous thing to fall into the hand of the Lord if you're not falling into his hand the right way. Amen. Glory to God. I thank God for a house that has liberty. There's liberty in this house. There's liberty in the spirit, amen. There's liberty in everything that we do in this place, and I thank God for that, amen. I truly thank God for our First Lady who taps into the Holy of Holies in the name of Jesus, and we give praise unto her being a vessel meet for the Master's use unto every good work. Today is a day that they have coined as the Mother's Day. But one would say, is Mother's Day really in the Bible? I will hold fast to say that it is. Because every leader that walked the face of the earth came where? From a mother. Without them being coming out of the mother's womb, there would be no men. There have been no leaders, good, bad, or indifferent. Amen. But one of the greatest jewels that came from the mother was who? Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. He came out of the birth canal as God impregnated. You know the story, Mary. But I would like to say to you, if you will, go with me to the book of 2 John. And I want to salute all mothers, not just in this place, but I like to salute the mothers around the world. Because without mothers, there would not be life. And without mothers, we would not have a Savior who died and rose on that third day on the hill called Calvary. Without mothers, the book of Proverbs, I do not believe, would exist because the book of Proverbs is titled as a her. Mothers are full of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, of the love of God. Why is that? Because they hold life so dearly. Life comes from a mother in the name of Jesus. But that's not our topic this morning. But that is to give honor and respect unto every mother that's in this ministry, and around the world. In the book of 2 John, beginning at the first verse, and I'm going to salute the mothers in the name of Jesus Christ. As we're saluting them that may be looking and listening around the world, we salute you as being a mother. You are very special in the sight of God. You're very special in the sight of this ministry. And without you, nothing can be impossible. Nothing can be possible. And definitely it's not impossible. Amen. In the book of 2 John, we find these readings in the first verse. Are you there? I need somebody to help me. Are you there? Amen. Or are you still caught up in the spirit? In the name of Jesus. And the word of the Lord says, the elder unto the elect lady and what? Her children. Notice it just didn't say a lady. It says an elect lady. What is an elect lady? It's someone that's special. It's someone that's different. It's someone that's been chosen, appointed for a particular thing. Do you hear me? It says, the elder unto the elect lady and her children, whom I what? Love in what? Truth. And not I only, but also all they that have known what? The truth. For the truth's sake which dwell what? In us and shall be with us what? Forever. The elect lady that is loved in truth shall always be with us what? Forever. He says, grace be with you. Mercy and peace from who? God the Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Father, what? In truth and in love. Grace and peace be with the mothers. In truth, from God the Father and the Son, Jesus Christ, forever, what? In love. So grace is with the mothers, peace is with the mother, the Father is with the mother, and the Son of God is with the mothers in peace, in love, and in truth. I salute each and every one of you that are mothers in this place and mothers around the world. May peace, grace, and love from God the Father, the Son, and truth in the name of Jesus. Let's give them a hand praise that may be looking and listening. God bless you, mothers. In the name of Jesus. So this morning we're going to continue in part two of our teaching. There's victory where? In his presence. And this morning symbolizes exactly what it was. There's victory in the presence of God. This will be part two of our teaching this morning. Victory in his presence. Defeat has no place. There's victory in the presence of God, and what? Defeat has no place. The Bible says that he has not what? Given us a spirit of fear. And fear is what? Defeat. But defeat has no place. Are you all with me this morning?
Amen.
Are you all up this morning?
Amen.
Can somebody say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
I believe you up this morning. Amen. Glory to God. So there's victory in his presence, and defeat has no place. What is defeat? Defeat is one, or defeat can be that I don't believe that I have victory. Defeat can believe that I don't see the victory that I have. But you have victory because he is the victor, and he is the victorious one. And he says, great is he what? That is in you than he that is what? In the world. So the world has no victory. The world has no defeat over you because of the great one in the name of Jesus. And as we were studying and it came to the Bible last week in the book of Luke, we came in the book of Luke from the 8th chapter, beginning at the 40th verse to the 56th verse, and we found that Jesus came into the city and they was waiting up on him. But one was in the city was a man named who? Jairus. Jairus was a very important person that was amongst them in the synagogue. There was many leaders, presidents, rulers, but Jairus was very important. And see, Jairus came to Jesus, even though the others did not come. But Jairus came to Jesus because there was a purpose for him coming. But needless did you know, if Jairus did not believe as the others believed, but Jairus had a purpose to come because Jairus at that point was being defeated. Amen? And he was still being defeated and still would have been defeated if he would have stayed in the presence of them did not know the one that can defeat what he needed. Do you hear it? We can be in the presence of many different things and many different people and we still act defeated. But we must understand that one has come and we must wait on him. And in the waiting, we shall overcome the defeat. Do you hear it? There's victory in his presence. And so the Bible continues to say it as the backdrop to launch you forward from last week. The Bible began to say that as Jesus came into the city, there was many waiting evangelists. They was waiting on him. How many of you know that we ought to wait on Jesus because the Bible says, be still and know that he is Lord. When it says be still, that don't mean that we don't do anything. But what it says, be still and don't try to do it yourself. Know that he is God, able to do what we cannot do, the impossible, but he is possible to do all things. And so the woman, we came down and we found that what? She had an issue. She had 12 years of problems and defeat. She had 12 years of giving over all of her finances to a doctor and many doctors. 12 years she was in defeat. 12 years she had a problem. 12 years she was giving up that which she had gained for 12 years. But it was not only until she seen Jesus. See, she would not got a victory if she wasn't excited about when he came in town. See, victories come to our life if we're excited about who's on the scene. Do you hear me? As this morning, he set the scene. He set the presence. He set where victory can take place. But were we all excited? That's a rhetorical question. And if we was all excited, then we could have came into his presence and immediately victory would have took place. Because the Bible says that the woman with the issue of blood for 12 years, immediately when she touched him, she touched into his presence, she stepped into victory, and the feet began to immediately move. Do you see it? She came into the presence. Into the presence of that which was victory. She stepped into the presence of victory. She crawled into the presence of victory. She plunged away into the presence of victory. She kept on with tenacity in the presence of victory. Nothing could stop her from getting in the presence of victory. And defeat was with her for 12 years. She was downtrodden, looked upon, cast away for 12 years of her life. But she was excited. It says when Jesus came back in, they were waiting. See, she was one of the days. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews, for the word preached unto us profit us. But it profit them not. Why? Because it was not mixed with faith to them that heard it. See, she heard that he was there, and immediately her faith began to stir up. Do you hear it? Her faith began to go to work. Her faith began to rise up. Her faith began to see that I am whole and complete, that I am healed in his presence because it's victory in his presence. She began to see her faith. She began to know that there's victory because of the present one. When you know that the present one has came and entered in, that's your time to move in his presence for that victory. And immediately that victory will take place. I'm telling you, Bible is factual. She had 12 years of issues. But it says her issue was stopped the moment that she touched him. Because she touched him in the victory. She touched him in the presence of glory. And immediately she was whole. In the name of Jesus. Now let's go to the book of Mark's Gospel. Mark's Gospel, the 5th chapter. And let's pick up the narrative. In the name of Jesus. Mark's Gospel, the 5th chapter. Hallelujah. Defeat has no presence. There's no defeat in the presence of our life-changing King. Because he says, O death, where is? He was calling it out. Show me, death, where is? O death, where is your victory? O grave, where is your sting? Death, where is your sting? And grave, where is your victory? He was saying, where is it? Show me. For the believer, it can't be seen because there is no defeat. There is no defeat because the Bible says he overcame the defeated one. There is no defeat. There's only victory. Only victory. Wherever you go, know that you have the victory. Wherever you go, know that you have the victory. Oh, it's quiet in here. You got to know this for yourself, that you have the victory. We have victory. And I'm standing boldly to proclaim there's victory over your life. I don't care if you don't believe it. I'm going to believe it for you. There's victory over your life because it's victory in his presence. He says in his presence what? Is a fullness of joy. When we're in the presence of God, we got to have joy. Even the Bible says when Nehemiah went before the king asked him, why has your countenance changed? What seems to be the problem with you? Don't you know that I am the king? But see, he was a king, but we have the king. And there's victory all the time in our king's presence. Amen. Because the Bible says he nor sleep nor does he slumber. He can't go to sleep because he's always watching. He's always in battle. He's always working things out for your good and my good. He is victorious because he is the king. He's the king. It's a matter of how we look at it and how we think about it and what we are saying to ourselves. You know, how many know that self communicate with self, but self don't talk right to self? Self come to self with an ego, or self come to self to downtrodden self. How many know self can pull yourself out of yourself and pull you away from yourself and pull you down? That self thing is a something, huh? Yes, so you got to even speak to yourself and say, get behind these self in the name of victory, Christ Jesus. Amen. Now you might say, Pastor, that sounds silly that I'm communicating and I'm speaking to myself. No, the Bible says you got to encourage yourself. Amen. You got to encourage yourself. Amen. Amen. You got to... People say, well, why you talk to you? I'm not talking to myself. I'm talking to the one that need to get behind me. Right. Because he's trying to come before me and in front of me, and he's trying to walk with me. So I got to say, get behind thee, because there's no defeat. Do you see it? We want to make things simple and plain. Are you there in the book of Mark's gospel? The 35th verse. Chapter 5, 35th verse, right? It says here, if you can, let's stand for the reading of God's word. We give honor to him whom honor is due in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I thank God for your tenacity, knowing that you have victory. You're a victorious people. And I'm going to pull every inch of the victorious out of you. Amen. If you got victorious hiding between your toes, I'm going to pull it out. If you got it in your garter belt, I'm going to pull it out. If it's in your back pocket, I'm going to bring it to your front pocket. Amen. If it's in your garage, I'm going to get it out your garage, because you need to start utilizing it. Amen. Victory is not to be placed on a mantle. Some of our victory got too much dust on it, and it's time for it to be used.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. There's no defeat, only victory. You know, victory is the very essence of the word that comes out of your mouth, because the Bible says, for the words go out to perform that which is set out to do, and it come not back to him void. God can't bring his word back void, because he is the victorious God. We got to start using the word.
Amen.
We got to start talking the word. We got to be in unity with the word of God.
Amen.
Even though you don't feel like it, see, it's there. You go again, Pastor. It ain't about your feelings.
Right.
It's about your victory.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
It's about you knowing that you got victory.
Right.
The mindset of the nominal Christian don't believe they have victory. Don't believe they have victory. Why? Because they think victory always got to be seen in the big bang. No, victory is that you got up this morning.
Amen.
That's victory.
Amen.
That's victory.
Amen.
Victory is that you're still right here now, because you could have been gone in defeat.
Amen.
Amen. Now, don't nobody lock them doors. Hallelujah. Don't lock no doors. It's against the law. We can't do that. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Are you there?
Amen.
And the word of the Lord says here, he says, while he yet spake, there came from the ruler of the synagogue's house certain which said, the daughter is dead. That's defeat. Why troublest thou the master any further? That's a defeated mind. Why speak to him? That's who you need to go to when something is dead. When an issue with a problem and you can't do it, you need to go to the one that can. Don't say you bothering him. He says he never sleep nor slumber. He's always up waiting on you.
Amen.
To give it to him.
Amen.
And the reason why we live in defeat, because we don't go to the one.
Amen.
We say, well, he's being bothered. No, he's never bothered. My God, 35 again. I'm getting caught up here. Let me get you so you can sit down. Amen. Now, I might need you to stay up, because I don't want you to go to sleep. While he yet spake, there came from the ruler of the synagogue's house certain which said, thy daughter is dead. Why troublest thou the master any further? As soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he heard what? The word that was spoken, he said unto the ruler of the synagogue, everybody repeat this with me, be not afraid, only believe. Let's say that again. Be not afraid, only believe. Now repeat after me. Be not defeated.
Be not defeated.
Be only victorious.
Be only victorious.
Be not defeated.
Be not defeated.
Be only victorious.
Be only victorious.
Be not defeated.
Be not defeated.
Be only victorious.
Be only victorious.
You may be seated in the presence of our life-changing King. Do you see it? Be not defeated. Be only victorious. For his victory where? In his presence. Because if we were defeated, we can listen to the voice that says, why bother the master? We can be defeated because many voices comes every day. A voice may came to you today this morning and say, why go to the church? They don't love you. They don't care about you. Jesus ain't doing nothing for you. Why come to the master and bother him? You never bother him. He says right there in the scriptures, the voice will tell them, don't bother him. She's already dead. Don't bother evangelists. Your situation can't be helped. Don't go and speak to the man of God, apostle, because you're too far in the hole. It's nothing that can be done. But the Bible says when two or three are gathered, what? In his name, there's victory in the presence. The Bible says in Amos 3:3, how can two walk together unless they agree? There's victory in togetherness and you're walking. Do you see it?
Yes.
How can you and me do what God called us to do, Brother Smith, and believe it if we don't believe the one who has called? We can't. And how can I look at you from the outer core and say, I don't feel like being bothered? I can't. How can you just come to a nominal place and just sit and say, I'm just here? No, you're not just here. He is here, and that's why you are here, and you need to get your victory.
Thank you, Jesus.
You need to get your victory. How many know when you come into this place, using as an analogy, you got a bucket, and the bucket is empty. But then you begin to turn on the faucet and you put the water into the bucket. It depends on how fast you want that bucket full. If you don't want it filled immediately, you just turn it on slow. But if you want it filled immediately, you're going to turn the water pressure up. The same way he has made this a bucket. It depends on how you want it filled. You can come in and let it be filled a little bit, or you can turn the whole volume up and get all that you want. Woo. Immediately.
Amen.
But it's all about how you come.
Amen.
Do you see it?
Amen.
Do you see that?
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. He taught in picture, parables, and precept. He made it simple where you can comprehend what God is saying in the word.
Amen.
See, that's, you've seen it, but you never heard it that way. Jesus never taught any new messages. He just taught them different ways to bring about the change for the one that was hearing. Do you hear it? Glory to God. And we're so thankful and grateful that he speaks to us that way. He brings the word a different way because we need to hear it a different way, but it comes from the same one that's speaking. Do you see it? Glory to God. Woo, Lord, this thing is good. Hallelujah. This is good. And then he goes on to say, 37, and he suffered no man to follow him save Peter and James and John, the brothers of James. And he cometh to the house of the ruler, which is Jairus, of the synagogue, and seeth the tumult and them that wept a while greatly. And when he was come in, he said unto them, why make ye this ado and weep? The damsel is not dead, but asleep. See, we'll come in and say, oh, they took my house. They took my car. They took everything from me, and we feel defeated. But Jesus said, no, it only lasts for a moment. He says, that's temporary. And that's why he tells us not to get hold on and tangled up into the things that are temporal. Our house is temporal. That's not a real home. Our car is temporal. That's not a real chariot. Our clothes we wear, that's not the garments that we're going to be dressed in. The shoes that we have on, we won't have none because of the preparation of peace. Do you hear it? The belt you're wearing, that ain't the real belt because you wear a belt of truth. The breastplate, you know, it's the breastplate of righteousness. You have a righteous breastplate. The helmet, the hats, the whatever you got. No, you have what? The helmet of salvation. Do you see it? And he says that we're what? Clothed in righteousness. This ain't righteousness. It's just the right thing I got on so I won't be naked.
That's right. That's right.
Do you hear me?
That's right.
This because I got this on don't mean I'm righteous.
That's right. That's right.
I got this on because I want to be right before God's people. Yes. Because I want to be no distractions. And you got to keep clothes on so there won't be no distractions, right?
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Let's make this simple.
Amen.
Let's make this plain. But he says that she was what? Dead. But see, you can't have a dead issue in the one that got victory. You can't have a dead issue before the one that has victory. I'm sorry to tell you this, but if that's the way you're believing, then I don't think we're in his presence. Because they said right here again, look at this. This is so good. I believe this is real good. He says right here, 39, and when he was come in, he said unto what? Them. See, them is the ones that didn't believe. Them are the ones wasn't happy when he was coming in. You got to be excited when Jesus come. You got to be waiting and say, oh, yeah, something finna happen, something going on. Something finna happen, something going on. You got to be excited. See, and that don't make sense to you. But see, everything don't need to make sense to you. But it needs to be in faith. Because faith can make sense. Amen. Look at this. He says right here. And when she was come in, he said, and when he was come in, he said unto them, why make ye this ado and weep? The damsel, which is Jairus' daughter, is not dead, but what? Asleepeth. And they laughed him to what? Scorn. See, that's why we said that everything God is going to do in this ministry and with the people that God is bringing here, because I'm not bringing, the Lord is bringing, because he said, if I be lifted up, I will do a drawing. I will do a deposit from heaven and credit it into your account on earth. Do you see it? I would do a deposit from heaven and credit it into your account on earth. So he says, if I be lifted up, I would draw all men, that's humanity. He says, I would do a deposit from heaven and do a credit to your account on earth. Do you see it? When God, you lift up the name of Jesus, he began to turn the heart of the people and he deposited the heavenly light and speak to their heart and he deposited into them, and then he accredited to the house. Do you see it? Does that make sense to you?
Amen.
He says, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. That means he's going to pull from heaven and place into your bank account on earth. That means he is moving people to be in the house of God where he desires. Do you see it?
Amen.
And then it goes on. Oh, is this good?
Amen.
And they laughed him what? To scorn. But when he had put them all what out, you can laugh at me, but I'm going to put you out. Laugh at me if you want to, but you got to get out of here. You know, the truth of the matter is that when it's victory in his presence and there's no defeat, no defeat, defeat has no place. Now, you, if you're not mature and you come in and one can sense that you don't have the faith to move in victory. But you're coming in the presence of defeat. I can surely, by discerning spirit of the Holy Ghost, know who has a defeated spirit. Now, if I tell you, then you could be immature when I say, get out of here. Because there's certain places that people cannot go if they don't have a victorious spirit. When we begin to walk as we always walk day in and day out, we are the ones that cannot have a defeated spirit. We got to have a victorious spirit because God desires for us to move and elevate in a different dimension, in a different position, and do some different things. But everybody won't be able to go. But all can come. Do you hear what I'm saying? Does this make sense? Does this make sense?
Amen.
You're very quiet now. I want you to hear what God is saying. And he told them what? To get out. Get out of here. Because of their belief. Belief. Doubt can kill what God brings life to. Doubt can hinder things, but God brings life because he says it's victory in his presence. He is life and life more abundantly. That's right. Prophetess Joyce, amen. And he said, and 40 again, and they laughed him to scorn. But when he had what? Put them out. He taketh the father and the mother of the damsel and them that were with him and enter in where the damsel was lying. See, he gonna take some people out. And it's good that he take the people out. Remember we talked the story about the wheat and the tare? See, a farmer and the wheat and the tare both look the same. But if you and I go try to pull it out, then we can tear what is good and we can tear it out. But the father, he says that he what took them out. See, Jesus already know what it is that needs to go. Because he could not perform what he wanted to do because some people in there had doubt. Some people in there had defeated minds. And defeat has no place when victory shows up.
Amen.
Do you hear it? Victory always supersedes that which is defeated. Jesus shows up and then what? Defeat has to go. When Jesus shows up, then doubt has to flee. In the name of Jesus. It has to go. And I know that Jesus is showing up here all the time. So defeat has to go. You can't come in a place such as God has desired this place to be is a victorious place. You can't come in here with a defeated mind. If you come in with a defeated mind and leave with a defeated mind, then you didn't believe the one that is in the place. Because they say they was waiting on him. We got to be ready and waiting for him. That victory will take immediate presence in our life.
Amen.
I can get up in the morning and I can feel defeated. But once I get into his presence, then I know defeat has no rule over me. Amen.
Amen.
Defeat has no place in me.
Amen.
Because I'm in the presence of the victorious one.
Amen.
I'm in the presence of the victorious one right now. Because he's speaking to me and I'm just relaying what he's saying to you. He's telling you that there is no defeat because I am present.
Amen.
I am present. And then he goes on to say here, he says, 41, and he took the damsel what by the hand and said unto her, Tilai Shikum, which is being interpreted, damsel. He began to speak in the heavenly language. He began to speak in an unknown tongue. He began to speak something that I just don't know what he's saying. See, that's why the first lady said, if you can speak in the heavenly language, you need to speak in an other known tongue because you're speaking to the victorious one. See, when we speak in our natural language and we come in gloomy, doomy, and sad, and we just say things, then he captured those things. Just think about this. You got the Seattle Seahawks, which is a Super Bowl champions. Glory to God. You got one of the world. You got the best team that's in the world because they've shown it to be truthful and factual. They have a young quarterback who is very talented. They have a defensive line, and they have everybody on the team that knows what they need to do. Just like that, he throws the pass. But if the one that don't believe that he can catch the ball, he will never run the route. Do you see it?
Mm-hmm.
If he didn't believe that he can catch the ball, then you will never run the route. If you don't believe that the one that can take away the defeated mentality and downtrodden mind, then you will never run the route. You follow what I'm saying? You will never run the route to get into his presence. You will never run the route to be full of joy. You will never run the route and say, God, not my will, but your will be done. It's a route that you got to run.
Amen.
Do you hear it?
Amen.
Not run away, but it's a route that you have to run. Everybody has to run a route. Everybody must understand the play. And the play is victory in his presence. When we want to run a prayer, only thing we all got to do is say, run victory in his presence. And everybody lift up their hands with joy, shouting and believing. Because everybody can run the route. Because the name of the play is victory in his presence. Amen. And we got a quarterback that's always going to hit the mark. I don't care where you run, there's victory over here. Glory to God. I don't care what you do, there's victory right here. Glory to God. I don't care if you're on a line blocking and hitting, there's victory right there because he can't get through. Do you hear me? In the name of Jesus. Lord, this is good because we have victory. God has placed us together for victory. And there's no way we can lose. There's no way we can lose. And he says, 42, and straightway the damsel, what, arose and walked. For she was, what, of the age of, what, 12 years. 12 years the woman had, what, an issue of blood. She had an issue for 12 years. And a young lady, which is the government, and a young lady was 12 years of age. Similarity. God knows that government will be upon his shoulder. Everything rises and lies upon the government of God. It's his shoulder. All issues lies upon him. That's why I say, all ye that are heavy laden, burnt down, busted, disgusted, confused in your mind, come unto me. And I will what? Give you rest. I will give you defeat. I will give you victory. I will handle the depression, oppression, but you got to come to me. Amen. You can't come to yourself. Amen. You can't go to your mama. You can't go to your daddy. You got to come to Jesus first, because Jesus said this thing is personal. Amen. When you come to me, then I'm able to do it. When you come to me first, then you can go and touch and agree. I can't go to my wife and say, honey, lay hands on me. No, I got to lay hands on myself, talk to him. And then I come to my wife and say, can we touch and agree on this in the name of Jesus? See, we got it misconstrued. That's why Jesus said, no, y'all get out of here. You trying to come to a man, but a man can't do what the man can do. You got to get out of here because you think it's man-made that's going to do this here. I already told you the doctors couldn't do that for that woman. I had to come and show you who can do it. There's no greater physician than me. And see, they was calling for the pall bearer. They was calling for mortuary. They was calling to dress her out to put her in the casket because they came in speaking defeated mentality. Oh, Jairus, you got it. Oh, brother Jairus. What kind of home going do you want? Jairus, do you want gold cartons? Or what do you want? You want a gold casket? They counted it out. See, people will count you out. They will count us out and think that we are defeated, that we are dead. But God says, no, those that don't believe, get out. Amen. Get out. Mm-hmm. Get out. Because I'm finna do something to show you. Hey. I'm finna do something that's going to show you. And when I show you, don't say, I knew he could. No, get out. You should have said, I knew he could when it was not then. In the name of Jesus. Now, you might say, well, Pastor, this is a hard saying. But no, we're talking victory in his presence. Victory in his presence. And we got to be bold enough to say, hey, get out. You got to be bold enough to tell people, get away from me. You're not talking to them, but you're talking to the one that's speaking for them. Didn't he say his word and he spoke it? Right. What? The word. And the word that he speaks brings life. It brings transformation. It brings fruit because there's victory in his presence. Amen. In the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. Fullness of joy. And it goes on to say, and they were what? Astonished with the great what? Astonishment. They was astonished with what? The great astonishment. See, they had to see something first. Do you see it? See, you're the ones that believe before God manifests the fullness of what he says he's going to do. You're the ones that are here now. And you seen what God is doing now. But then the other one's going to say, wow, it was really God. It was really Jesus Christ that was with them. Oh, we already do that. We can sit back, not arrogantly. We can say, oh, already, we already knew that. because we believed him when he was coming.
Yes.
We was waiting on him, and now he is here. So it's victory. We had victory back then, but we weren't arrogant enough to say, oh, well, no, we're going to do what God says to do and continue to do it because we know we got victory. And when you know you got victory, then you continue to do what you're supposed to do. Don't get comfortable.
Amen.
Don't get laid back. Don't get complacent just because you know you got victory. Yes, I got. Go to the book of Joshua, chapter 7. But we know that there is victory in the mind, in the heart. God what speaks to the heart. And when the heart is spoken to, then the mind will catch up with what the heart is hearing. That's why it says, he who has ears, let him hear what the Spirit said. See, the Spirit speaks to the heart. And then the heart will calculate to the mind, to the ears. Now, you can hear a lot of things, and if it get to your heart the wrong way, then you can go south. What does south mean? South means hell. You'll go the wrong way. You'll go to the roads of wide that leads to destructions. Amen. Are you in the book of Joshua? Joshua. We know that Joshua was what? Moses' minister. He ministered unto who? Moses. And before the torch was passed, Moses brought him out before the people and said, this is going to be the predecessor. This is the one that's going to keep us going on into this victory. This is the one that's going to lead us into the victory and into the presence of God. I only can bring you so far because of the mentality of your mind. You had a defeated mind, but God showed his love, his mercy, and his grace and kept us from being defeated. But see, we can get so complacent and so familiar to where we really will get defeated. Are you there in the book of Joshua? I keep telling you to go to the book of Joshua, right? And I'm not even in the book of Joshua. Can I go to the book of Joshua?
Amen.
Would it be okay? Let's go to Joshua chapter 7. Let's look at verse 1. Joshua 7, verse 1. Joshua 7, verse 1. We're talking today victory. Defeat has no place. There is no defeat in the place of the believer. Our mindset. That's why he says renewing of the mind is not that you're going to go and somebody going to give you a new mind, that you're going to go to the store and get one of those diet pills and say, whoa, I got a new mind. Oh, they came out yesterday with new mind pills, and I'm going to run over to the Walgreens because that's the only place that they can sell them. I'm going to go over here and buy the whole rack of new mind pills. That's a defeated mentality because it's not the pill. It's in the will that can change the mind. Do you get it? It's not the pill, it's in the will that can change the mind.
Amen.
Now, they do have help-alongs, amen? Glory to God. All of us need some help-alongs. You know what a help-along is? That can help you know, help you do what you already know that you can do, right?
Amen.
That's called a help-along. In the automotive world, they call them come-alongs when you're doing towing. Come-along. It just helps you pull more. Understand? We all need some come-alongs. We all need somebody to help us pull more. Who is the one to help us pull more? Jesus.
Amen.
He helps us pull more of the heavens down on earth.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
Glory to God. Are you there?
Amen.
Glory to God. First lady, you just tickled. Glory to God. Bless you for your tickling. Look at this. You can get complacent because you know you always got the victory. Until where you can be defeated. Look at this. It says here, verse 7:1. But the children of Israel committed a trespass in the accursings. For Achan, the son of Carmi, the son of Zadi, the son of Zarah, of the tribe of Judah, took of the accursing, and the anger of the Lord was kindled against the children of Israel. Do you see it? And Joshua sent men from Jericho, to Ai, which is beside Bethaven of the east side of Bethel, and spake unto them, saying, go up and view the country. And the men went up and viewed Ai. And they returned to Joshua and said unto them, let not the people go up, but let about 2,000 or 3,000 men go up and smite Ai, and make not all the people to labor thither, for they are but what? A few. You getting complacent because you had victory. Now you're saying what you gonna do. You minimizing your power. You're minimizing the authority. Do you see it? We came in, we always come in and we give honor and glory to God and move in the presence of God. Since we know God's presence is with us, we don't do that no more. We just come on in. See, he's numbering the people. Oh, we already got victory, and God had a number who already took it. But now let's pull back a little bit. We know we got victory. Don't get familiar. Oh, it's victory, but don't get familiar. Because defeat can come. Defeat can come. Look at this. Does this make sense? And then he goes on to say, so there went up thither of the people about what? 3,000 men. And they fled before the men of what? Ai. And the men of Ai smote of them about what? 36 men. For they seized them from before the gate, even unto Shebarim, and smote them in the going down. Wherefore the hearts of the people melted and became as water. And Joshua rent his clothes and fell to the earth upon his face before the ark of the Lord until the evening tide, he and the elders of Israel, and put dust upon their heads. And Joshua said, alas, O Lord God, wherefore hast thou at all brought this people over Jordan to deliver us into the hand of the Amorites to destroy us? Would to God we had been content and dwelt on the other side of Jordan. Now he's saying, God, hold on. What has happened? See, they got complacent. They forgot the one, the victory in the present, till you start wanting to name your own victory. Do you see it? And go on here. He says, O Lord, what shall I say when Israel turneth their backs before their enemies? For the Canaanites and all the inhabitants of the land shall hear of it, and shall envern us around and cut off our name from the earth. And what wilt thou do unto thy great name? Now drop down to verse 12. Therefore the children of Israel could not stand before their enemies, but turned their backs before their enemies, because they were what? Accursed. Neither will I be with you anymore, except ye destroy the accursed among you. Do you see it? Got so complacent, you went into battle, and you did some things you shouldn't have done. God was with you in battle. God always defeats in battle, but now you do some things that you don't know you don't supposed to do. And then God comes back to remind you, yes, there's no defeat in this place, but you went out of place, and therefore defeat has come upon you. Do you see it? There's victory where? In his presence, and out of his presence, anything can happen. Amen. Anything can happen. And look at this, he says, 13, up, sanctify the people and say, sanctify yourselves against tomorrow. For thus says the Lord of Israel, there is an accursed thing in the midst of thee, O Israel. Thou canst not stand before thy enemies until you take away the accursed thing from among you. Amen. There's some things that's in the midst of the people that God says, you got to get this thing from amongst you. You got to take it away from amongst you. You got to take the defeated mentality from amongst you. You got to remove it from amongst you. Amen. But see, there was one that did not do according to what God says by the scripture. The scriptures are factual and will always lead to truth. Look at this. And he goes on to say here, he says, in the morning, therefore, ye shall be brought according to your tribes. And it shall be that the tribe which the Lord taketh shall come according to the families thereof, and the families with the Lord shall come by household. And the household which the Lord shall take shall come by men by men. And it shall be that he that is taken with the accursed thing shall be burnt with what? Fire. He and all that he have, because he have what? Transgressed the covenant of God, of the Lord, and because he have what? Wrought folly of Israel. How many know when we come together? I'm from the tribe of the Simmons family. Do you hear it? You're from the, now from the McIntosh tribe. Do you hear it? You're from the Ellis tribe. You're from the Smith tribe. You're from the Dillard tribe, and so on. Do you hear it? We're all from different tribes. But the ones that from different tribes, we should take the same command. Do you hear what I'm saying? It's victory in the presence of God. Even though you're from a different tribe, we all take the same command from our tribal leader. Amen. And our tribal leader is Jesus Christ, the Lord thy God. And it says that he took every tribe and he began to go through the tribes. He began to search things out. He began to find out, why did you move from the victory to the defeat? We're going to get down with this and we're going to find out. And then he says right here, verse 16. So Joshua arose up early in the morning and brought Israel by their tribes. And the tribe of Judah was taken. Do you see it? And he brought the family of Judah, and he took the family of the Zerahites, and he brought the family of the Zerahites men by men. Azariah was taken. And he brought his household men by men, and Achan, the son of Carmi, the son of Zedad, the son of Zarah, of the tribe of Judah was taken. And Joshua said unto Achan, my son, give, I pray thee, glory to the Lord God of Israel, and make confession unto him, and tell me now what thou hast done. Hid it not from me. Do you see it? You can move in victory because it's victory in his presence. But you can take that which is not right, and God will immediately bring defeat upon you. And God will begin to go through the whole house. He began to sweep tribe by tribe, person by person, and he began to face you. Why is it that you once was in victory and now you're moving in defeat? What is it that you have done? What is it that you're not bringing to closure? What is it that you're not exposing? Why are you walking in dark? And all the other tribes is being persecuted for that which you have done from one tribe. Do you see it? Amen. Because all of us are from a different tribe. But God does not count it lightly that he's going to do everything to just one. He will separate that one, and he will find out what is the problem, what is the issue, because we all have issues. Do you hear it? Amen. There is no defeat, and defeat has no place in his presence. And the reason why defeat comes and overbounds and tears down, because we're not listening to the one that we was moving in victory. What keeps us from moving in victory? That's a rhetorical question. God is speaking to every last one of us that are tribes in his kingdom. What's keeping us from moving in victory? What are we hiding, or are we hiding anything as Achan did? He had to go through every tribe and he had to single them out until he found what was going on. Now let's go on. And then we're going to go to where the victory takes place when we listen. When we listen. And he goes right here, 19. And Joshua said unto Achan, my son, I pray thee, glory to the Lord God of Israel, and make confession unto him, and tell me now what thou hast done. Hid it not from me? And Achan answered Joshua and said, indeed, I have sinned against the Lord God of Israel, and thus I have done. When I saw among the spoils and goodly Babylonian garments and 200 shekels of silver and a wedge of gold and 50 shekels weight. Then I covered them and took them, and behold, they are hid in the earth in the midst of my tent and the silver under it. See, when we try to hide things from the Lord, and God says, all that I have belong to thee. All that you have belongs unto me. Don't try to hide anything from me, because I can hinder the move. I can hinder the move. I can stop the move because you're hiding something. And then God would immediately go and he would begin to search things out. He began to turn over things until you confess that I got it hid under my mattress. I got it hid in my pillow. I got it hid behind the left fender well of my car. I got it hid in my tires in the rim. I got it hid, Lord. But God says there's victory in my presence. And defeat has no place. But you're acting defeated because you're hiding things from me. Do you see it? The Bible says everything is what? Open and naked before God. God says, don't hide from me. All you tribes, don't hide anything from me. And let's go over to the book of Joshua chapter 8. See, they went up and they hid, and God gave them directions. And they hid. Before you go there, I want to close with this here. And go down to 7:25. And Joshua said, why hast thou troubled us? The Lord shall trouble thee this day. And all Israel stoned him. See? They had to what? Stone him. They had to deal with him. They stoned him with stones and buried them with fire. And after they had stoned them with stones, and they arose over him great heaps of stones unto this day. So the Lord turned from what? The furnace of the anger, wherefore the name of that place was called the Valley of Anchor unto this day. See, they had to deal with them. See, God would deal with some that just don't want to do right by him. See, the world is being dealt with. And to say the world is being stoned by God. Because of what's happening in the government, what's happening around the world. The world is taking and hiding from God, and God is going through every tribe. God is going through every tribe. Every ministry is a tribe. Every ministry is a tribe that has been given the name. And God alone allows us to give a name to every church, every ministry. But God is now beginning to sweep through every tribe. God is now beginning to sweep through every tent in the tribe. And before God can sweep, there will be them that come and confess that I've been hiding, I've been taking, I've been hoodwinking, I've been stealing. And then God will have to shut it down. God will shut it down. Do you see it? Amen. We cannot get so complacent in his presence. Even though God has given us victory and he shall give us continuous victory. But we cannot get complacent and say, this is what I'm going to do. This is what I believe I'm going to do. This is what how I'm going to move. This is what I'm going to say. This is how I'm going to show. God says, no, you're going to move in defeat. If you want to be victorious, then you move according to his presence and what he says. Go to Joshua chapter 8. I want to leave you on a being high-minded, but not so highly of yourself. Amen. Glory to God. He says here, and the Lord said, who said, and the Lord said, who said, and the Lord said unto Joshua, fear not, neither what, be dismayed. Take all the people of war with thee and rise and go up to Ai. Do you see it? See, go up to Ai. And then he says, see, I not what you did, not the numbers that you took, but see, I have given into thy hand the king of Ai. Now you're coming into the victory. Do you see it? You went in defeat because of what you did. Now you're coming into the victory because God says, take up. And then he says, see, I will give into your hand the king of Ai. You went and tried to get it yourself. But and when I give it to you, it can't be taken. When you are walking in my victory, in my presence, then no weapon formed against you can prosper. Do you see it?
Amen.
And when you're walking in my presence and my victory, then what you have, what you say you can have.
Amen.
Because it's me giving it to you and not yourself.
Amen.
Look at this. This is good. And then it says, I have given unto into thy hand the kings of Ai and his people and his what? City and his land. He just didn't give you one thing. He gave you all the people. He gave you the city and the land. See, now you're moving in victory because he says, it's me that's telling you to go up. It's me that's telling you to go in. It's me that's going to give you the one that's ruling in the land. I'm going to even change the hearts and minds of his people. I'm going to give you his people. They're going to follow you because they know victory is in the presence of God. Amen. And then he says, I'm going to give you the city. The name of the city was the king, the Ai, but now it's going to be the name of the Lord. I'm going to give you what? The land. The land they said belonged to that man down the street. But no, I'm going to change the land's hand. And it's going to be given to you.
Amen.
Do you hear it? In the name of Jesus. This is the Bible and this is what we must believe. And then he goes on to say, and thou shalt do to Ai and her king as thou didst unto Jericho and her king. Only the spoil thereof and the cattle thereof shall ye take for a prey unto yourselves. Lay thee an ambush for the city behind it. Joshua arose and all the people of war to go up against Ai. And Joshua chose out 30,000 what? Mighty men of valor and sent them away by night. And he commanded them saying, behold, ye shall lie in wait against the city, even behind the city. Go not very far from the city, but be ye all ready. Do you see it? Don't go far from the city that I'm going to take and give into your hand, but be ye therefore ready. Don't move away too far from the coma span away, but be ye thy ready. Do you hear it? He ain't necessarily saying you got to stay right here. Don't get complacent and think it's right here. Don't go too far, but be ye thy ready.
Amen.
Y'all don't get this.
Amen.
He didn't say stay right here. He didn't say right here is going to be it. He didn't say right here from H3 to H9. He didn't say this is going to be it. Mm-mm-mm. He didn't say this is going to be it. What did he say? He says, don't go too far. Don't go too far. He already said that he's going to give the king. He's going to give the people. He's going to give the city and he's going to give the land. But he says, don't go too far. He says, but be what? Ready. How do you be ready? You already ready because you're excited about him coming. You're excited not only because he's coming, you're excited because he's already here.
Amen.
And if he's here, you got to be ready when he say go. You got to be excited because victory is in his presence. When you're in his presence, there is victory. There is no defeat. Outside of his presence, anything can happen. But in his presence, there is victory.
Yes.
In his presence, he will tell you not just to go up, but to look up. The Bible says, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and finisher of my faith. Just don't go up, but look up. But don't go too far. I'm not saying that you got to stay right here. But I want you not to go far from the city.
Amen.
Because you need to be close. Because what I'm finna do is ambush the city and take all of it. Glory to God. And if you're too far, you won't be able to consume everything that I said I'm going to give to you.
Amen.
Lord, help me.
Amen.
Relay this in a spiritual wholeness. God says, this is not just a place, but this is the city. And in this city, I'm going to give you those that are in charge of the city. I'm going to touch their hearts and touch their mind. Not only them, but the people. Not only the people, but I'm going to give you the city and I'm going to give you the land that the city is in.
Amen.
He says, just don't go too far.
Yes.
Just don't. I got to leave that alone. Just don't go too far. Just don't go too far. But the revelation of a difference, some not going far enough. And then he goes on to say here, my God, we almost out of time. Just a couple of more scriptures, and this is good. And we will continue this if Jesus tarrying is coming, because we're talking about victory in his presence. Defeat has no place. If we're out of place, then we can be defeated. But we're in place, then we always will have victory. Victory over everything, every situation, every area of our life. And he says right here, 4, and he commanded them, saying, behold, ye shall lie in wait against the city, even behind the city. Go not very far from the city, but be ye ready. He says, be ye ready. And I and all the people that are what? With me. Be ye ready, and I and all the people that are what? With me will approach unto the city, and it shall come to pass when they come out against us, as at the first, they will flee before them. For they will come out after us till we have what? Drawn them from the city. What seems like not a tactic to you, but it is working for God. And God says, don't get too far. You got to be close to understand and be ready. When I'm finna do this, I'm going to bust a move. If I bust a move and you're too far, you're going to be out of place.
Amen.
Be ye ready.
Amen.
Be ye ready, God says. Be ready. He said, be ready. Verse 6, for they will come out after us till we have drawn them from the city. For they will say, they flee before us, so they think. They think we're gone. As at the first, therefore we will flee before them. Then ye shall rise up from what? The ambush. See, God is setting this thing up. He is setting this up. He is setting it up. Do you got to really see, men and women of God. God is setting up an ambush. If you stay in his presence, if we invoke him to come, if we go into the presence of God, if we invite his presence in, God will let us go up.
Amen.
In this city.
Amen.
That's why it takes every tribe.
Amen.
Every tribe.
Yes.
God, who? You got to see it. It's victory in this.
Amen.
Lord, ooh, wow. My God, my God, my God.
Amen.
He says every tribe. He says right here, then ye shall rise up from the ambush. See, you're being hit right now. God got you on the backside. Where? People have to come and search for you sometime. They only can see it by the sign. But God says there's victory in my signage. And God says, I'm going to take you up. I'm going to give the people in the city, the kings, those that rule and make decisions. Not only that, I'm going to give the people. I'm not going to just give the people, but the city going to be laid out for you. And the land's going to be laid out for you.
Amen.
And he says, 7, Then ye shall rise up from the ambush and seize up on what? The city. For the Lord your God will what? Deliver into your hand. And it shall be when ye shall have taken the city that ye shall set the city on fire. According to the commandment of the Lord shall ye do. See, he says, see not you, but see it's me. I have commanded you. And we're going to stop right there. God says that you will set the city on fire. What you set the city on fire, you're destroying that which is old. And the fire that you're setting is not a fire that's going to destroy the city. It's a fire that's going to purify the city. Right. When God speaks by his written word, and God speaks to every tribe should hear what God is saying. And every tribe has a responsibility to make sure that their tribe is in order. The tribalettes, mama tribe leader, daddy tribe leader, the whole tribe has to be in order. Because if we're not in order, then we can move what we think is his presence to where we're moving in defeat. And when we're not in his presence, we can tell the household is in defeat, the children is in defeat, attitudes and all kind of things come in defeat. But God says, no, I'm going to get down to the very essence of this thing and I'm going to move it. Because I desire that you go up into the city. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to give you the kings and the people and the land. But it's going to be me that's going to do it. And I want all the tribes, he says, to be what? With him. He says he desired that everybody be with him. Nobody be left behind. Now there's a choice that we make. Do I want victory or do I want to be defeated? That's a choice. And I pray when God opens up and provokes and we provoke his presence in this place that we move in victory. If you don't believe that there is something in your life that's defeated, just say, I'm not sure, I'm going anyway. I'm finna get in the presence of God. I'm getting in the flow of what God is doing. And if it happened to breathe upon me, then so be glory to God. Let it breathe upon me. I'm not going to miss it. I'm not going to miss it. In the name of Jesus. Do you love him?
Amen.
Is he good to you?
Amen.
Oh, he loves you so much. He adores you because you are his victorious people. You are the tribe that he can count on. You're the tribe that he knows that you provokes his presence to come in the name of Jesus. It may seem silly, it may seem awkward to you, but that's what God wants you at your awkward moment. Amen. That where he can move in upon you. In the name of Jesus. So we love him because he first loves us. Let's give him a hand praise. We thank God for the marvelous things that he is doing. And we pray that he continues to show us that we are walking in victory. And that we have the city, that we have the victory, because Christ Jesus is our victory. Amen. Let's stand to our feet in the name of Jesus. As it was spoken and declared, and I still believe it, that I speak right now, victory. I speak victory in the life of everyone that is here in this building. I speak prophetically the abundance of victory In the name of Jesus. If there has been an aching in your life, we denounce them right now in the name of Jesus. That it be no more. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And Father, that these are your people that you take up. And you get them, God, in the position to take everything from the king. And the people will follow them, and the city will be them, and the land will be theirs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, Father, we believe by your resurrected Son. On this day, God, you've shown us there's victory in your presence, and defeat has no place. For I declare and decree that this place is a house of victory. And the men and women, God, that's here shall go with us onto the other side. And that you will be glorified and magnified in this place in Jesus' name. Father, it will be without remiss if the doors of the church would not be open. For them, God, that do not know you, but have been lost in the world. Father, we declare and decree, as you said in your word, that no man should perish, but all should come into the knowledge, the truth, and the revelation that Jesus Christ is Lord. Father, we say unto them that may not know you and desire to be saved and come into the kingdom family, that the doors are open. Come forth and receive Jesus. Let him be the Lord of your life. Let him be the center and circumference. Let him be the one that can fill the void in your life and show you what is right and what is true. In the name of Jesus. And Father, secondly, we ask those, God, that have turned their back to backslider, for you say that you are married to the backslider, one that will not turn their back, but they have slidden back for some reason, some cause. And they have fallen into defeat, God, because they fell out of victory. They fell out of your presence, Lord. Bring them back into the rightful position of your presence. In the name of Jesus. Father, we call them right now to come forth. And Father, is there one dirtly that may not have a place, God, a place where they know where they can be saved, the place where they know there is the presence, the place where they know they can be taught the word of God, the place where the truth is being taught, God. Let them come forth. Hallelujah. Not to be a number, but a member of the body, the whole body, where the truth is spoken. And Father, you said there's victory in the presence, God. And fourthly, for those that desire to pray in the heavenly language, the evidence in speaking in tongues, God, you said there's power in the word. In the heavenly language, there's power. The Bible says in Romans 8, for we do not know what we are to pray for, but the Spirit knows, with moanings and groanings who give utterance unto God. It's straight line communication. Just as the woman with the 12 years of issue of blood, she touched a straight line communication and immediately she was healed. Just as Jairus' daughter, they counted her out for dead. But Jesus said, those that not believe in the way that we ought to believe, you got to get out that I can do this work. And she said that she was just sleeping. And therefore she rose, and the Bible says, give us something to eat, for she is hungry. Father, let your people arise, because they are sleeping. Give them something to eat, the word of God, for they are hungry. In the name of Jesus. And Father, I thank you once again for this day of all the mothers around the world and the mothers that are in this place. God, continue to strengthen them, encourage them, and guide them and direct them. Lead them, God, in all spiritual truth, because you said the elders, the lady elect, and they are elect ladies, anointed, appointed, chose for your cause to give birth unto this world. I thank you for them, Lord, and I pray for their protection. And I pray for the men and women around the world. Father, we lift your name up on this day. All that believe, say to God,
be
the glory
in
all that he has done, that he has said, and that he shall do in the day of the coming of Christ Jesus. I believe there's victory. I believe There's victory. I believe there's victory. Defeat. Defeat has no place. Defeat. Move. Move now in the name. In the name. In the name. Jesus. 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 Victory. Jesus. Victory. Jesus. Victory. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You ought to give yourself a hand praise. Oh, you're patty caking. That don't sound good. If that was for me, as Brother Smith say, would be good. But if that's for God, then that sounds not right. Because there's victory in the praise. There's no defeat in you. And we thank him once again. I believe we have something for the mothers. That's a token of our appreciation.